We are ready to start. We can start now.
Okay. Hello, everyone. A very warm and good morning. Good evening. It gives me a very great pleasure watching such a huge gathering for today's webinar titled 3D Printing, a Factory on Your Desk. I, Ranjit Kumar, Chief Manager, Public Relations and Consultancy on Technology and Science, at the very outset, congratulate and welcome you all for today's webinar. We are very much obliged to get an overwhelming response for this webinar from all over all the states in India, and also from places like Australia and Ethiopia, which proves how young aspirants like you are eagerly waiting to learn and upgrade your knowledge in the field of 3D printing, which is otherwise also called as additive manufacturing. In order to make this webinar a decent success and for smooth functioning, we have muted all your mics, and we also request you all to switch off your videos to avoid distractions to the speaker while delivering his keynote. And also, I, on behalf of Own Technology and Science, make a request to all the participants to stay tuned so that we have a very important announcement to be done at the end of the session. And now, finally, without making any further delay, I request the CEO of Own Technology and Science, Mr. B. Sravan Kumar, to take over the session and to introduce today's resource person.
Thank you, sir. I, B. Sravan Kumar, CEO OTS, welcome all the participants for today's webinar entitled 3D Printing Factory on Your Desk. I take immense pleasure in introducing our resource person for today's webinar, Mr. Vigneshwaran. Mr. Vigneshwaran has completed both his bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering and also master's degree in manufacturing science and engineering from Vishweshwaraya Technological University, Belgaum, and he was exceptional throughout his education. He, with a passion, started his career as an assistant professor and helped many students not only academically but also morally in fulfilling their dreams of building a strong career. He worked on various projects funded by Innovation and Entrepreneurship Development Center Program, IEEDC, and Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, MSME, which include study of sliding wear rate of cold rolled steel specimens subjected to zirconia coating of various thickness, and design and fabrication of indexable milling fixture for BE1600 tooth segment, to name a few. He also published technical papers in some reputed journals and also received the Best Paper Award for an article titled Effect of Aluminum Alloy 2011 on Sliding Distance and Wear Rate Subjected to Titanium Nitride Coating of Various Thickness, which was presented during the first International Conference on Recent Innovations in Engineering and Technology. He was selected as one of the resource persons for a three-day national-level conference on New Era in Manufacturing by 3D Printing Technology, where he delivered his keynote on latest trends in 3D printing technology, for which he received a standing ovation from the delegates and participants. He is a person who always thinks that one can be successful enough if one can communicate ideas in a decent and easily understandable language, and that led him to acquire a business English certificate offered by the University of Cambridge. Currently, Mr. Vigneshwaran is associated with Weltech Multitech, Dr. Rangarajan, Dr. Chakuntala Engineering College, Chennai, where he is serving as an associate trainer for placement and soft skills. Now, without making more delay, I invite Mr. Vigneshwaran to take over the session.
Mr. Vigneshwaran, please unmute yourself.
Hello?
Yeah.
Please. Yeah, am I audible, Ranjit?
Yeah.
Please okay, I'll just record the session.
Okay.
Just a minute. Okay, is the screen visible for all of you?
Just I'll go. Yeah.
Yes, it is visible.
Good evening to one and all. Already some persons have given my introduction. There is no need for my introduction, right? So I'll be just starting with my session. That is 3D printing. 3D printing a factory on your desk. This line, it suits for everyone. That means this 3D printing, a factory on a desk in a sense, if you have a 3D printer with you, it is like you are having a factory on your table. That means what and all they are doing in a factory, they're just fabricating a thing and finishing it to a component. The same thing with a small 3D printer, you can do that. So the workers also will be minimum, and moreover, the time also will be less. And accuracy is awesome. There is no question about that. 3D printing is also called as additive manufacturing. Before going to this topic, I just want to tell you what is the necessity of this 3D printing. Ever since the evolution of mankind, man has been developing various things. First came manufacturing. Manufacturing means completing a product into a finished component. So whenever man was just doing this manufacturing methods, he found some innovative things of doing it with more accurate things. That is 3D printing. There comes the 3D printing. 3D printing is also known as additive manufacturing. So just I want to tell what is manufacturing. Manufacturing means a finishing a component. That means fabricating a raw material into a finished component. So just these things I'll be discussing today. So first we'll see the evolution of the 3D printing, subtractive manufacturing, what is additive manufacturing. Then I'll be going with the 3D printers, industry, working, types, application, and future scope. So before going to the topic, I just want to tell you what is subtractive manufacturing. Subtractive manufacturing means you are removing a material. I mean, you are just removing a material just with the help of a tool you are removing. So there will be lots and lots of wastage of material. There is no question about that, because whenever you are removing a material, definitely the chips will be falling. We cannot recycle the chips. We just want to throw it to the garbage. Subtractive manufacturing means you are removing a component. Every layer, the component will be removed. You can see in this diagram how it is done. So additive manufacturing means it is quite opposite to that. Instead of removing the things, you are just adding the things. The process of adding materials layer by layer in order to get a finished component is called a 3D printing. Let's see how it's done. See, just see here, a man is just with a 3D printer. What you're seeing in this pic is, this is a pic. So this is known as a 3D printer. He has a laptop with him. He is designing a component. The same thing, he's with the help of a memory card, he is just transferring it to this and making it to a component. That's it. With all these components, he has finished with the 3D printer. So there is no need of going to a factory. There is no need of keeping n number of workers with you. You itself, you can do this if you have some training. That's it. There is no need of any skill. Very easily you can learn this 3D printing. So as I told you, it's a method of converting a virtual 3D model into a physical object. So, and the next thing is you are just adding the layers. Successive layers are laid. That means one layer is laid, another layer is laid. Moreover, on that another layer is laid till the finished component is got. Let's see this on step by step. Before going to this, just I want to remind you the history of the 3D printing. The first 3D printer was developed by Charles Deckard. He is the person known as Charles Deckard of some systems corp. He invented this in the year 1984. First, he didn't coin the term known as 3D printing. He just named the technique as stereolithography. Stereolithography. And also in the year 1986 itself, he got a patent for this. And you can see this machine. Initially, the machine was like this. It looks like a complicated thing. First, it was a big thing. There is no later the developments are made, but he is the person has to be rewarded, because with his development, the world has taken to a next step. Now, later in the 1990s, first he discovered in the 1984, later in the 1990s, other companies also developed these 3D printers. And later on, 2005, the first color printer came, that is color 3D printer came. Now, what is 3D printing and how does the 3D printing work? Let's see this. You can see a man standing before a 3D printer, how he is small and how the 3D printer is big. Okay, this is the thing, which there is lots and lots of variations in the sizes also. So the image which you're seeing here will cost more than 5 crores. There is no need of purchasing this. It is suiting, it will be best suited for an MNC company. Fine. This is the thing, the working, the simple thing is you just need a printer for this. There is no need of anything. You just need a printer, a raw material and a software. That means your 3D printer, some raw material. I'll tell what the raw materials you're using and a software, that is Autodesk or AutoCAD, whatever software it is. And within this, you can finish this component. See the accuracy of this component, how it is. See this accuracy. It is created with 3D printing. Even if you're going by conventional methods using subtractive manufacturing, in no way you can do this with this accuracy. Even a CNC machine, it's there, but it needs a lots and lots of G codes and M codes. But 3D printer, which just a 1 or 2 months training, you can just do this and throw it away. Just, it is a working of this thing. And I just want to tell the process of this. If you understand the process very clearly, you can just learn the 3D printing in a easier way. First, that's foremost thing you're going to start. After that, what you're doing, you're just adding some filler material in this. At the backside, one tube will be there. You are adding some filler material. After that, you're just giving the command. What it does is the print head will apply the resin. I'll show the image, then you'll understand. Then the powder layer dries. Whenever it is heated, whenever powder is heated, it'll just get dried. That powdered layer along with some resin, it is applied as a layer on the bed. If it is completed, it will go and just you can remove the complete model and you can finish the component. Otherwise, you have to go to that thing. Again, you have to come. Till the layer is completed, you have to go like this cycle. And again, you have to come. Till this, it will be repeated until you're completing. Once you're completed, you can remove the completed model and you can finish the component. That's it. So the step one, see, he has this man. What he does, he thinks of a cup. He thinks of a cup. He wants to design that cup. What we used to do, there is no need of going and ordering it in any factory or purchasing somewhere. If you are well-versed in your thing, you can just do this. Only thing, you should have some innovations. That's it. Innovative things is the main thing. There is no need for you to be an engineer or a big person or any VIP. Just you have to be innovative. That's it. The other thing is you should have some basic knowledge about drawing. That's it. If you are mechanical, well and good. There is no need of anything. So he's just thinking of a cup in this laptop. He's just designing this cup. First, he's just designing the layers. The main reason for designing these layers is you are according to that bed, the print bed of yours, you are designing the size of the thing because on the print head, the printer has to go. He is designing and this CAD file is created. The next is he created the CAD file. Step one, he is creating the CAD file. The step two is this CAD file is exported to a 3D printing machine. How it is exported means using a memory card. If you have a memory card, well and good. It's just taken, you are just saving it in a memory card, taking that memory card, inserting in this, at the side, there is a panel of this machine. There is a panel. You are fixing in it and just awning. That's it. Because you are already given the dimensions, the print head, what it does is, it will be just giving the layer by layer, like this, one by one, like this, it will be just moving. The print head will be moving like this and this. And once it is done, you are getting the component. See, he's designed a star here. That star came over here. And this is the thing. If you see this, you will be understanding this. This is the print head. See, the material will be supplied in this hose, some sort of filler material. If the filler material is heated, definitely it will be somewhat like a paste. The paste with the heated component is layered on the bed. See the arrow marks, how it moves. Y direction, Z direction, and X direction. This is the X direction. This is the Y direction. And this is the Z direction, vertical, Y and X. When this component adding, see this, from the bottom it starts. From the bottom it starts. One by one it comes. The layer is finished off. See the accuracy of this. The contours, and the depth of this, how neatly it is maintained in a 3D printer. 3D printer has taken this world to the next level. There is no doubt about that. See, the minimum head, the material supply, X and Y and Z directions they are giving, and you're getting the finished component. This is the thing. First, the tool comes here, first step. Second, the tool starts to lay the material. One layer is completed, again it comes back, another layer is completed. So one by layer, it is just going on like this. There is no need of anything, just it is going on till the, you see the step five, how the contours are done. For contours, it's just going to the depth, that is Z direction. So at last, in the number six, you see how neatly it is done. The contours are done to the perfect level. Even in a conventional CNC, you need to have some programming languages like G codes and M codes. You have to take some special training and all. But this, if you have some basic knowledge about the 3D printer or some diagrams, you can design whatever component you want. That is the thing. And see, you got the component now. Your first step, you are thinking about the model. Second step, whatever you are doing, you just transferring it to the file using a memory card. Third step, you got the product. See the accuracy of this. It's a cup he has designed. First, he thought of a normal one. Later on in the diagram, he changed how the cup accuracy and the finishing of this component, you see. You can just try this in your home if you have a 3D printer. In next decade, in a ton of 15 years, I challenge you that each and everyone will be having a 3D printer at home, because due to this COVID and COVID cases and all, many things have changed drastically. Now the advancement will be to the next level. Otherwise, we cannot match with the market scenario, because we have to take to the next level. That's why there is a mandatory thing that you have to learn many things. So 3D printing is the gateway for you to be succeeded in life. So this is the thing, actual object. So this is the 3D CAD model. In one slide, I'm just explaining you. 3D CAD model, what you're doing, you're just thinking, you are just giving in AutoCAD software. Using .stl file, you have to store this. This .stl means stereolithography. That means like DOC, PDF, like that. You have to give some formats, then one day it will be stored. Suppose your name is Ramesh, ramesh.stl. Suppose your name is some Vikas, because that STL, like that you have to store. After storing, the slicing software, that is means this software which transfers is known as slicing software. What it does, it gives the layers. See the cup of the 3D model and see the layers. One layer, second layer, third layer, fourth, up to that it completes. That means additive manufacturing, right? So additive manufacturing means layer, one layer, on that another layer, on that another layer, till that finished component is completed, it keeps on adding the material. This is the 3D printer. Okay, fine. This is a 3D printer. How the object is there? Just see here. See the accuracy of this. If the coloring is given, the first model and the last model will not have any sort of difference. Only thing that the color, later on we can add that color. Fine. There is no need of, suppose you are just wishing for a cup like a star. That means the cup should be in the form of a star. You want to have, but it is nowhere available in the market. What we used to do, we used to see the online sites like Amazon, Flipkart, whatever it is. But there is no, if you have a 3D printer at home, if you are well versed in this drawing, you can just have it on your table. That's why I quoted as a factory on your desk. So the 3D CAD model is stored in STL file, slicing software, and layers are given one layer over the other, and you got the 3D object. These are the raw materials. See the raw materials. The raw materials just, the 3D printing is specialized in for making the plastic components or plastic or some ceramic components in particular. It is not best suited for the ferrous and all. The developments have come for the ferrous, but it is, if you're comparing with the ceramic materials, the 3D printing is awesome. For that raw materials, we are using polylactic acid, nylon. Nylon is the best material for this. The second one, nylon. Nylon is the best thing. The next thing is polycarbonate. Next, carbon fiber. And next comes acrylonitrile butadiene styrene. So ABS, it is known as ABS. So these are the different raw materials that I used. Now, there are some 7 to 8 methods, but for your basic level, these different methods, three methods you have to remember. First is selective laser sintering. Selective laser sintering. Next is stereolithography, SL. And next comes fused deposition modeling. One by one, I'll explain. These three methods are very important for because whenever they are designing something, the companies follow these three methods in particular. Now, next comes the SLS method. See here, this method, how it works is they are using a laser light. Laser is powerful. You know the applications of laser, light amplification for stimulated emission of radiation. So laser, it can do many miracles. In this, what it does is it passes a beam of light to a scanner. The scanner, what it does, just like a focusing mirror, it focuses on a table. Before that, this setup has to be arranged. Very simple. I'll explain in your easy way. See, it has two pistons, one and two. One is moving in upward direction. Another one is giving in downward direction. You will have a question in your mind. Where does this roller, what is the use of this roller? Just you think in your mind, what is the use of this roller? Roller, what it does? Very simple. We have to deposit the powder material. I told you, you have to deposit the powder material some way so that only the part can be completed. Now, where you have to deposit the powder? There is no hose or nothing. Just through this powder, there will be some minute holes. Through these holes, the powder is deposited, just like this. The roller will be moving back and forth. Once it moves like this, the piston will go up. Once it moves like this, the piston will go down. So like this, see this part, how it is completed here. I'll show you a video. In that, you can easily understand. So the laser light comes here. The laser light gives the heated component here, like this. When this powder material settles here, already it will be in the form of powder. This scanner heats the powder. Once it's heated, we can give the finished component. You might have seen in forging, right? Forging, what we do? We heat the rod and just we can make it to whatever desired shape. The same principle is applied over here. What it does, whenever you are heating some powder material, it will be somewhat in the form of a paste. Using that, you can form whatever material you want. See the part, how it is completed. I'll just show you a video in the YouTube. I'll just create that video here. I just want to show you that. It's just a 2 minutes, some 2 minutes video. See, this 3D printing in action, laser sintering. Everything starts with the idea. That is your idea. Your idea becomes a computer file. The cup you are designing in a computer. The computer file is prepared for the machine. Later, using that, you are just taking the memory card and just you are transferring it to a thing. Later on, you're just giving this machine. See here, very important. There is a roller on the top. On the top of this, there is a focusing mirror. The laser light is already passed. The laser light is not visible for you. The laser light passed. Once it is done, there are two pistons. The pistons is not visible for you, but the pistons will be inside. How it works, you see. The temperatures rise now. Obviously, the temperatures rise. A laser hardens the powder like this. Like this, the hardens the powder. A new layer of powder is spread out. One layer is spread out. This process repeated like this. You see how the finished component is got. The roller gives the material over there and see the accuracy of this. Your model is lifted out and you can finish it by hand itself. Extra powders, something, you can just wipe out. Done. Your product is done. So now I just want to tell you the same thing. SLS method is best suited for this. So using a roller, you can just do this in SLS method. Now, I hope that the SLS method is easily understand. You can easily understand the SLS method. The same thing, we are going for stereolithography. That is second method. First, we saw SLS method. Next is stereolithography. This is always the best one. There is no doubt about that. But the problem is, it is costlier. The raw materials which are used in this are very costly. There is no doubt in support with that, UV rays also is passed. because it's powerful. There is no need of, there is no question of accuracy and all, because the laser light accompanied by UV rays is passed over here. You need a computer for this. There is a model. Along with this, it lays. So there is no need for you to understand this, because the major thing which is which you are coming across in your life is, first is the first method, selective laser sintering, and the last method, which is fused deposition modeling, which I'm explaining in the upcoming slide. This is the fused deposition modeling, the third method. The first method, roller, second method, UV rays, third method is fused deposition modeling. That is layer by layer. I shown you some three or four slides back. What I have shown, fused deposition modeling is an additive technology used for prototyping and production applications. You see how the axis is moving. One, like this, one, two, and three. In three axes is moving and just completing the material. This is called as bed. So you need to know the bed dimensions. If you give the material, if you give the drawing beyond the bed dimensions, definitely there will be error. You cannot print. So you have to have an basic idea of what you're drawing. This bed dimensions are very important for you. If you don't know the bed dimensions, then there is no need for you to know the path. Whenever you're drawing some sheets, you are within the boundaries you're drawing, right? The same thing. This is the boundary for it. So if you are giving in the edge, you cannot print. There is a range for this tool head to move on the bed. Suppose if you're giving more, it cannot take. So you need to know what is the scale for the bed. The bed dimensions, X axis, Y axis, and Z axis need to be known. Otherwise, there is no need of proceeding, and there is no use of proceeding also. It will just stop. And this is the thing. In a detailed manner, I'll tell you. See, this is known as spool. Spool in the sense, it will be just like a thread. You are seen in your houses, right? Whenever you want a thread, you're just taking it in a form of a spool. This is a spool. In this spool, there is a hose. Already in this spool, there will be some raw material. I already told you what and all raw materials we are using. So it can be ABS, it can be nylon, it can be polyamide, whatever it is. What it does is, it goes like this. Here, what it does is extrusion takes place. You know what is extrusion, right? Extrusion, you might have studied in your manufacturing. It is form of, you are seeing your toothpaste. In toothpaste, how you are squeezing? Just like that, it will squeeze a tube. It will just squeeze a tube. The remaining part of the material will be just rushing out with a high velocity, because squeezing is on both sides. Whenever you're pressing the toothpaste, what happens? The paste will just come out with a high velocity, right? The same thing, the extrusion, the extruder, what it does is, it just squeezes the tube. When it squeezes, already it will just come out. This paste will just come out and it will just keep on the bed. Already I've shown you the bed, right? This is the heated block. The bed will be maintained at a temperature of 70 degrees to 90 degrees. This is enough because it's just a plastic material, right? Plastic material, 70 to 90 is enough for melting. It's not a cast iron or a steel so that you can keep for 500 or 600 to be melted. It's just a plastic material, nylon, polyamide. 70 to 90 is enough for melting it. So the heated filament is forced through a nozzle. Nozzle means you know what is a nozzle. Here, the print head prints in XYZ position. So some basic diagram of drawing you should know. Otherwise, it's very, very hard for you. That means you have to be innovative. That's it. There is no need for you to be a doctorate or whatever it is for this to understand. Some innovation is needed. That's it. Because 3D printing, innovation is the key. So here you see X, Y, and Z axis. How it comes? Spool, filament is in extrusion. Here two rollers will squeeze it. The material will come out like this. A heater block melts it. Thereafter, it comes on the bed. Whenever a heated powder comes out, generally it will be in the form of a paste. Once the paste is dry, it will be a material. That's it. Simple technology. X, Y, and Z. X axis, Y axis, and Z axis. Whatever it is. So depending upon the thing, it will just lay the material. Here you see the component is they are created a dies over here. Dies, six-phase dies. So this is the thing of fused deposition modeling. You see the accuracy. They have created a basket in fused deposition modeling. This is the printer. As you can see, this is a spool. See how nice it is to see. In the diagram, it is not visible. you are just giving the thing over here. This hose, the hose comes here like this, and it, this is the bed. This is the bed on which it lays the finished product. And you can just take the finished product, make it to dry, see the accuracy of this. If you want to design whatever component you want to be a design a basket in the form of an in the form of an oval thing or a rectangular thing or a circular thing, whatever thing, you can just design it. If you are having the drawing, nothing is impossible in a 3D printer. So see the accuracy of this in the fused deposition modeling. I just want to show another video regarding this fused deposition modeling, which I have collected here. Just a minute. So this is the 3D printer. The spool, as I told you, it comes through the extruder. This is like this. Once the extruder is done, the nozzle starts to print. How it is printing? Layer by layer, layer by layer. It is adding the material. That's it. So just a 5 seconds video it is. It is adding the material. There is no complications in it. It is just adding the material. Once the extrusion is done, the adding goes on taking place. So it is just simple as that. There is no need of anything. Now, you have seen we have seen what is selective laser sintering. We have seen what is stereolithography. We have seen what is fused deposition modeling. I just in a chat, I want to explain you all. When resolution comes into picture, fused deposition modeling will not have a resolution because there is no need, because the extrusion is taking place. You can get it very soon. There is no need about that. But resolution, as far as the resolution is concerned, FDM is very less. Out of 5, the 2-star is coming. In stereolithography, and you can see the stereolithography, in all aspects, it is superior. See, in as far as the resolution is concerned, accuracy is concerned, surface finish is concerned, ease of use is concerned, everything is super. But only concern is stereolithography. It is quite costly compared to FDM. That is the main thing. We are not able to, the many companies are not able to take this FDM. Sorry, stereolithography. Stereolithography is always costlier compared to FDM. And you can see the superior qualities of this. Resolution, 5-star. Accuracy, 5-star. Surface finish, 5-star. And there's a throughput, how you're getting that final product, 4-star. Complex design, 4-star. Ease of use, 5-star. So all over, it is taking the maximum rank out of these 3. The one and only thing, it is quite costly. That's why we are not able to accommodate it. So, and fused deposition modeling, why it is used common method means, you can get the component. Compared to that, you can get a component in a easier manner, and moreover, it will be economical. Compared to stereolithography and selective laser sintering, FDM is always economical. Even if you want, if you are having around 60 to 70,000 with you, you can just purchase a printer. Whereas for stereolithography, the basic model will start from lakhs. That's it, in Indian rupees. So fused deposition modeling is always economical for the middle class people. Suppose if they want to start a business firm, it is best to go for fused deposition modeling. It is also suited for mass production. Suppose you want to manufacture toys, FDM is always the best one. Now, you just see here, this is the size of a printer. A man is standing inside a printer. Believe it or not, he is standing inside a printer and see the component with him, how big the component is. He's standing inside a printer, and this is the nozzle. This is the nozzle. It had already started to print. It has already started to print the job. Everything is going in a superior manner. So it is in a well and decent manner. So already he has given the diagram in a laptop. With that, he has to transfer it to the memory card. He got this diagram. If you want to give this in an industry, and it will take more, I mean, more complications will be there. And there is no doubt that this accuracy, it cannot be maintained even by a superhuman. The 3D printer works like a robo. So this is a very important thing. This laptop, and see the size of the printer. It is known as oral printer or massive or giant printer. So the printer sizes, where I already told you, we'll just see the applications part of it. So here comes the major thing, applications part. 3D printing is dominating in all the parts, in all parts of this thing. First in medical, second in food, third in games and entertainment. Do it yourself in the sense, see, do it yourself. You can do whatever component you want. Suppose you want to, you're telling your friend that I want to start some toy shop. So there is no need of going and purchasing in wholesale market. If you are having this, just you need some raw material, right? For raw materials, you need some money. That's it. While you're selling the product, you can just take it in a double manner. So that is not a problem. You are doing it yourself. Pop culture, even in some, you want to manufacture some decorative items for pop culture, you can use. Defense and space also, they're using it. Believe it or not, for defense, Indian Army, Navy, whatever it is, for rifles, producing the rifles, they're using this 3D printing. Fashion and retail. See, fashions also, they're using it. Now, if you see in Amazon and Flipkart, whenever you're seeing in fashions, you will be attracted to many designs. That main thing is advertisements. Advertisements are attracting us. The same thing, if you have a 3D printer and you are having some extra accessories, you also can advertise your own product. Because 3D printing not only gives accuracy, it also gives some superior looks. That is major thing. Medical also, there are some studies that it has, it is manufacturing some tooth components. Even some tooth components also, we can just manufacture in this. See here. Yeah, some toys is manufacturing. See the quality of this toy, how it is manufacturing. Idea, got to design, you got a 3D model. This is the printer. Use a small thing, you can just use this. Industrial design, for industrial design it is used. And this is a prototype. If you ask me, can we print a car? I cannot assure you we can print a car, but I can assure you that we can print a prototype of a car. There is no doubt about that. In future, definitely the cars also will be coming. I know, don't know about that. But you just see a man is sitting inside a 3D printed car. It's just a prototype. We cannot run because we need an engine for that. Okay. So he has just printed a car using a 3D printing, layer by layer, whatever it is. See the accuracy of it. We cannot make out that it is manufactured by a 3D printer. First, when I took the training over this, I did not believe that it is manufactured by 3D. But the thing is, it is manufactured by a 3D printer. See, the man is sitting inside it. It is just a prototype. You are seen in many things, right? If you're going to showrooms, they'll be just keeping some prototypes over there. The same thing you also can do. If you want to start a own company, car company, like some rainbow or something, you can just give your own thing. So if you want to manufacture from some cars, some cars in the shape of some pentagon or hexagon also, there is a chance of doing because you're having a 3D printer on your table, factory on a desk. And you see here, artists in many foreign countries, they already started this. Artists are creating models through this. Now there is no need for you to go and draw on the paper. There is no need of rapid prototyping. Rapid prototyping, you know, right? So you need a template for it. For the template, you have to design first template. You have to keep draw the template and no need of reading. Just one AutoCAD software. Is there any difference between the monitor and this one? You see, only the color difference. See the accuracy of this. This he has done some flying dragon. That's it. The flying dragon is done in two different ways. One is in a green color and somewhat different colors are there. But see the accuracy level of this printer, 3D printer, how it is doing. And this, you can do some chocolates material also. Chocolates, what and all material you are using, you are just applying in the nozzle. That's it. Whenever we need some heated material. When you are heating a thing, that component, it'll just come like this. Chocolates also you can prepare. So many things are come. But the one and only problem is now the 3D printing is not going to the hype right now. But I can challenge you that in the next decade, in the sense for 10 or 15 years. Definitely everyone will be knowing this, and moreover, it will be a mandatory thing. We should know this, like just like computer. Before 20 to 25 years, the person skipping a computer will be a lakhpati or crorepati. Now it's a computer. The computer has been the common thing in almost every home. Like that 3D printer also, the price will come down. When the demand rises, the price will come down, obviously. So the 70,000, 80,000 printers will be available for just 10 or 15,000. Everyone can purchase it with ease. There is no need for you to be a graduate in operating this. So just you need the practice of knowing the drawings. As already told you, in medical industry, there's a thing. See, they'll take the dimensions of your jaw. They know the dimensions of the jaw, they can easily print this. So you just need to know the dimension of the jaw. Dentists use this. So there is no need of making the patients wait for 1 month or 1.5 month. So you just come after 1 month, we'll just give you a jaw. No, if your jaw is broken, 1 hour, 1.5 hours, your thing is ready. Only thing is, you should know the dimensions of your jaw, because it will not be suited. Just like this, they'll take the dimensions. See this. In a blue color thing, they have taken the jaw and they have prepared this. So physicians can use this 3D printing thing and to go beyond this. These are the objects that are printed with a 3D printing. Objects that are made with 3D printing, you can see how accuracy is maintained over here. And moreover, the colors also, depending upon the filler material you use. Toys, you can see the Rubik's Cube over here, Rubik's Cube and some toys material, how they are easily attracting the things. Even if a man wants to design some toys, he needs to sit and he needs many tools to do this, like spanners, whatever it is, like a screwdriver. No need of anything. One 3D printer, everything is done on your table. If your keyboard is gone, you can just do the replacements also. So replacements also can be done using a 3D printer. So the replacements are the key here. The replacements in the sense, just a minute. The replacements, you can, if your space bar is broken, you take the dimension of the space bar and you get replace it. There is no need of going to the shop and purchasing. Moreover, in definitely if the 3D printing is manufacturing these things, I think everyone will be an entrepreneur in the next decade or so, because it will be mandating that everyone will be selling. 80% of them will be an entrepreneur. Definitely they will be making some global trade also. See, the complex structures also can be done here. Complex structure in the flower vase. The flower vase, if you want to decorate your new home or a new constructed house, you can just do some complex structures also, like airplane models. See the cube. Can it be manufactured through hand? It's very, very difficult. See the accuracy of it. So see this thing. It needs some CNC machines with experienced CNC professionals. But with the 3D printing and some knowledge about the printer, you can just do this. So animated characters, you have seen the Avatar movie and all. So with these things, definitely I'm saying the animated movies will be coming more. If the 3D printing is reaching the people more, definitely I'll be saying that it will just create some more and more and more publicity among the people. So because some Sony Pics have just manufactured this, you see the accuracy of this, the animations movies, animations in the sense, here you see many people are just joining and laughing in here. It's just like watching a cotton movie, but everything is manufactured with a 3D printing. You cannot make it that it is manufactured with a 3D printing. Only thing is, if you want to do this complex structure, you should have some practice. Nothing comes without a practice. So see here, artificial arms for disabled. A South African carpenter is assembling a robo hand for a boy called Dipanio. This boy was not having fingers in his right hand. Using a 3D printer, additive manufacturing, they are just giving this. For this, this is not an overnight job. There is lots and lots of precautions that has to be taken. It is not like doing toys and all, because they have to know the dimensions of the kid, the hands of the kid, and it has to suit the kid. And moreover, there should not be any side effects. Once the kid is wearing it, there should not be any sprains that is experienced by the kid. Because usually in medical therapy, there will be always some testing. Then only it will be on humans. Directly, they will not go and fix it. But it has been successful and he is operating with his hands. He didn't have fingers in his hand by birth. He is a boy name is Leon Dipanier. So with the 3D printing technology, a robot hand has been fixed on him. This is a medical use. And already told you, do it yourself. In application part, I have just told what and all things you need to do. You are having a printer, right? You are just doing the drawing. What if in your free time also, you can do whatever thing you want. Suppose if you go to the market and just sell it for 300 or 400 rupees, it's well and good. Some pocket money will be there for you. That means, I just want to tell you, even you can have some pocket money with you, even that means while you're studying, there is no need of disturbing your study and going for some jobs and all. Just in your home itself, in your Sundays or in your pastimes, whenever you're not doing anything, you can just do these toys and get some money. That's it. So using Windows 8, you are doing this, and do it yourself. You can just, she's just done some dress materials also. So the first 3D printer in space to prepare a future made in space, the space manufacturing NASA has done, they have just done this experiment. That means some space dresses also they are manufacturing. So these are components on demand. In future, not only on Earth, even in, for the people going in space and doing some revolutions over there, some achievements over there, they also will be doing having many components that is manufactured with the 3D printing. See, this is known as, this is a gun known as a liberator. This is a gun, I repeat, this is a gun not made up of metal. It's a plastic. That means it has some parts in it. That means it's a 3D printed handgun. If the target is fixed, it will not miss it. That means with a small zoom thing, you can just shoot it whatever you want. This is one of the gun name is Liberator. Even the target is 5mm or 10mm diverted, it will just go and shoot the target. Liberator, it's a gun that is used in defense. Defense, we cannot manufacture it because it will be a crime. If you manufacture these type of things in your home, it will be a crime. You should have a proper license for this. So, just I want to go through some thing. Aundal in it's there in according to the American dollars. See, up to $15,000 also it will be there. Model U print form. These are the different type of printers. So, $1 is around 70-75 rupees, whatever it is. So, $599, $1,500, whatever it is. You need some initial investment for this. Suppose if you are want to start a business. I'll not tell that it is a, overnight you can become a multi-millionaire using a 3D printer. It's wrong. Everything will start with a small step. Take a 3D printer, just with a small step you proceed. Definitely with your hard work and dedication, you can be a winner. So these are the some of the models. Based on your budget, you can just pass and you also can be an entrepreneur in future. So low end, the low end of this is around 86,000. This is the low end part. That is around 86,000. Mid-range, you just see the difference. 86,000 and the low end and the mid-range is 1 crore. This one. And next is high end is 5 crores. See the size of it. So a man will be just up to this monitor. That's it. He's just operating with a monitor. He's just transferring that. There is no need of taking the memory card out. You are giving the drawing and give the thing. Everything will be printed. It's just looking like a CNC machine, but everything will be done up to the accurate level. So specifications, there are some specifications for this. So for the envelope and the layer thickness, it is around 0.254 mm. Modeling part ABS. Support material is soluble, always soluble support material. The price. So these are the specifications you need to know. And adoption over time. See the consumers, how it does. If the time are passing by, the consumers are becoming more and more. The advancement of 3D printing in over time is it's immense. There is no doubt about its advancement and all. And this in this mid of pandemic, I'm telling you, when this corona gets over, there is no doubt that many people will go through advancements because the jobs are getting lost. So what happens is they will move to the new technology. Instead of giving employment to 10 people or 15 people, if one people can do, they'll go for it. So it's better to go for 3D printing method. So the consumers have gone more. The reach also has gone more. Suppose before 5 or 10 years, people knowing the 3D printing was very less. Now each and every one are knowing the 3D printing. There is no doubt that there will be a course called BE 3D printing in future also, because 3D printing is dominating the thing. So the conventional machining process will gradually decrease. So some advantages of the 3D printing are, it's a rapid prototyping method. I mean, it's a kind of rapid prototyping method where there is no need of taking the template and drawing. Everything the computer will take place. It's a clean process. There is no doubt about it. In subtractive manufacturing, the chips will be falling and you have to segregate the chips and complex shapes can be produced. See, in this, the complex shapes with ease you can just do it. And moreover, it is easy to use. There is no skilled persons that can be required for this. And moreover, there is no need for you to reduce your design complexity, and it is cheaper process also for your investments. The disadvantages, everything has a pros and a cons. No matter whatever it is, every machine has a cons. I am not supporting the 3D printing fully. There are some cons. Let us see. The process is slow. You cannot order the 3D printer just to finish it like you command. It is an additive manufacturing method. Each layer by layer only, it has to deposit. We have to wait. Components do not have enough strength because these are ceramic materials. Ceramics, if you just you can just crack it with a stone. And the cost of raw materials. Initially, the raw material cost is a big matter here. Some thing will have more cost, like nylon and ABS and all will be having more cost also. Misuse of technology. Some people, there is a chance that they will misuse this technology. That is the main problem. Misuse in the sense, I already showed you a gun. There, some people will just misuse this technology and they also will be knowing to how to prepare a gun, means they also can do. Guns, it is licensed. Okay, you cannot do with your own thing. You need some license for it. So at last thing, you can make your own toys at home. There is no need of going to the market. And if your kid is if your kid wants some toy, he sees in advertisements, if your kid is ordering some toy, you can just go to the 3D printer, make it by morning. If you do, by afternoon or evening, you can get the toy and you can just present it to your baby. In future, let us see the future thing. Future, if you are losing some TV remote battery, if you are losing some TV remote battery today, if you're losing from TV remote battery, you can print the battery cover. That means you are losing some cover, you need the cover, you can print the cover. But in future, you can print your remote also. Because right now it is taking the prototype. Prototypes only, it's manufacturing. But in future, it can create whatever models you want, even engines. 3D printers are getting cheaper and better. See, I already told you, as time passes by, the cost also will come down. This is the major thing. The research is going on. Now, many people are doing the doctorates in it, but they'll be knowing this. So the researchers are going on that they are manufacturing some organs for it. Even the organs are getting manufactured over here. Within a decade, 3D printers will be commonplace in house. See, within a decade, within 10 or 15 years, everyone will be having in house. There is no surprise in this, because in next 5 years, I challenge you, it will be the 3D printing cost will be just like a television sets. It will be just like a 30 or 40K. So yeah, in another decade, over 15 or 10 or 15, just like a mobile phone you can have. There is no doubt that using a mobile phone also with a remote control also, you can just do it. There is no need of taking the chip and inserting it. The advancements also will be more. Now, for the freshers, it's very, very important. Just listen here. The impact is felt already. I want to tell particularly for freshers. See, there is no need for you to just panic regarding this job interviews and all. There's a simple thing. Everything has a way. You just learn new technologies like this 3D printing. The impact of 3D printing is already felt. Many people are going for courses. In this pandemic, nearly 34 to 40% of college students have finished the 30 to 40% of college students in India already completed the training in 3D printing. So they are just going on a fast track. So they want to learn new things. If you learn new things, the CGPA of you is no matter. Even if you are having more arrears, don't worry about that. So learn new things and be an entrepreneur. The impact is felt already in rising, big data sharing economy, middle class in emerging markets, climate change also, it is predicting natural resources. And also in the impact, in these things, they are just doing this. See, 2015 to 2017, how the advancements are taking place. Internet things, new consumer ethics, privacy issues were there in 2017. But now there, nothing is there. Robotics, it's dominating. Autonomous transport is dominating. Artificial intelligence, it's dominating in the last 2 to 3 years. Advanced materials, I already have shown you many materials. Biotechnology part also, it's dominating. So this is 2020 at present. So suppose if you're a second year student or third year student, in another couple of years, definitely more advancement will come. Job opportunities are immense. There is no need for you to panic. These are some of the job prospects for 3D printing. See, research and development, R&D. If you want to pursue your higher education in your R&D, I want to do some research in 3D printing. Well, it's an ocean. 3D printing method is an ocean. You can do immense and immense studies in it, research and development. Architecture, You can do whatever houses you want. You want to design your ceiling. You want to design your flooring. You can do. Education also you can teach. You can go to various colleges and schools, collect money from them, give training to the people. So this also like this, you can take the money. You can earn money. Biological and scientific modeling. If you're innovative, you can rule in this field. Out of this four, biological and scientific modeling, if you are well-versed, if you are just having some innovations, you can go to foreign places. You can just do your dream job. You can be a research scientist also if you're knowing the scientific modeling. So courses offered. This is a very important thing I want to share. See, some courses are offered for 3D printing. If you search in the internet, you can just get this. QTUF 3D is a 3-month course. In this QTUF 3D course, they are just giving some learning model tools for 3D printing. See, some tools are explained over here. The tools in the sense, they'll just tell what are the tools are here. They'll give you the design process also. And they'll do some small components. They'll make you also to do this. Learn basic sciences and explore mathematical modeling. You need mathematical modeling is a basic thing. At least you should know how to design it. It's a 3-month course QTUF 3D is providing. If you are certified with a 3D printing, 3D printed certificate, definitely it will enhance your interview things. Your resume will have an additional impact. So next is MDS 3D. This is another sector where the 3-day seminar will be taking place using simple models. Or every time they'll be just giving a 3-day seminar. Think 3D. It's the largest 3D platform in India. Think 3D. It's the largest. If you want to go, invest money, learn it, come out. Sometimes they also will assist you for job. They'll give placement assurance also. BOTZ, whatslab.com. What these people do is they go to colleges, they go to schools, they give the training, they sell their 3D printers. See how and all money they are just, we can earn. Life is not the, and you, there are more and more challenges that are waiting for you. These courses, you can just do it. So boatslab.com, you just imagine, suppose you're well-versed in your 3D printing, suppose you're well-versed in your 3D printer, you can just go to the schools and colleges, take your 3D printer there. Suppose you have purchased it for 86,000 or something. You're explaining with some courses. You're explaining the students. For the courses also, you can take the money. For the printer also, you can just sell it over there and come. So there will be some double income for you. And this one is very important. Areas where 3D printing are expanding. See, 2017, it is 27% for the production parts. Couple of years, 52% it has been increased from 27, almost double. Production parts, if you are manufacturing or a mechanical, well and good. Production parts from 27 to 52, more than, it is already crossed 50. 27, 52, almost double for production parts like spanner, bolts, whatever it is. For bridge construction, for civil engineers. Well, this also is very good. From 2017, the impact, the areas, it's expanding. 3D printing parts areas are expanding. 2019 is 39%. 39% of bridge construction products are done in 3D printing. Repair and maintenance is very less. See the thing, 2017 is 14%, more than double. More than double the repair and maintenance workers are there. So just you want to do some repair and maintenance means that it is a vast topic. Yeah, there is. It is not limited to mechanical alone. So if you are a maintenance engineer, it is well and good. 2019, it is gone to 38%. I stress and tell you that I specify you, it is 2019, last year. Now it has been, it will go up to 60 also. There is no doubt because it is just changing drastically. 17, jigs, fixture and tooling. This everyone knows what is a jig and what is a fixture. It's a work holding device. 30% it was in 2017, but 2019 you see 37%. Almost there is an increase in everything. So for you, there is no need to panic and all. Everything you need to know that you should know what is, in which areas you are strong. In that area, you should go. Suppose you are a doctor. If you are MBBS doctor, 3D printing, you can do some researches like doing some artificial hands, artificial legs, like that you can do. Suppose if you're a mechanical engineer, go for doing some spanners that we can, doing some things that is like work holding devices also you can do. Suppose if you're a civil engineer, do some things like a ladder, like a spring ladder also you can do in a 3D printing. See, I want to stress you that 3D printing is not specialized in doing the steel parts, but now the advancement have come. Steel parts also it is doing. And recent surveys have insisted that steel parts also it can do. The one and only thing, while doing the steel parts, you should increase the temperature beyond some level. I already told you the bed temperature for ceramic parts is 70 to 90. But while you are doing steel parts, it has to melt the steel, right? So you have to increase the temperature. Now, right now, the ceramic parts only they're doing. The steel parts is not very famous and all, but as the time will pass, easily pass. And you know what? At the steel that is manufactured from a 3D printer, recently they manufactured, it is stronger than the steel manufactured from a conventional method, 3 times stronger. So these are the advancement that is taking place in a thing. So 17 and 19, this is the thing that is happening in India. Okay, so this is the impact. There's no need for you to panic and all. These are the references that I have taken. So conclusion, what I'm going to say is, it's a relatively new technology. 3D printing is a new technology. No restrictions on industry. Almost the cost also will reduce. Full effects, that means full effects on business will be there. And the society is still not known. That means many people now also, I know I told you 30 to 40% students are doing the training in this, but the people beyond that, if you are there working professionals, they are not just having the interest to know about the 3D printers. It's not the thing to earn only money. Knowledge is an ocean. We have to know whatever things that is coming. Everyone knows what is mobile. There is even a small born, newborn baby knows what is a mobile now. So like that, 3D printers, everyone should know, because it is a thing that can take the world to the next level. That means resistance to change. That means, before a decade, how it was, now how it is, the 3D printing is changing. You can ask me a question that unemployment, regarding unemployment and all. Unemployment will increase. There is no doubt about that. But if you are strong in your thing, if you are innovative, unemployment will not be a problem. Moreover, if you are becoming an entrepreneur, there is no need of getting a panic, you know, while working regarding the jobs and all. Many people are ruling the world through this entrepreneurship. They're getting the trainings, they're just taking the money. If you are well-versed in 3D printing, you can start your own firm. Some small scale industry, you can start by two lakhs or 4 lakhs. You can start a company offering jobs for some 2 to 3 people. You can just start a firm. That firm can just take to the next level also. The thing is, only thing is, the time should be good and your talent also should speak. So these are the things that I want to conclude in this. Moreover, it's an immense opportunity. I just want to thank the OTS for giving me an opportunity to deliver the lecture, and you're open for the query section. So I just hand over this to the speakers so that they can just ask for the queries, so that whatever thing I know, I'll just share it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I am Ejana. So I would like to ask few questions which we have received from a few of the participants. Number one, do they print metal using 3D printing? This is a question asked by Mohammad Ghosh, AS.
Yes.
Okay.
Sir, actually, metals also it can print. Metals, yes. Nowadays, they are just giving the advancement in printing a metal. Because ceramics, printing only ceramics will not replace the conventional things, because conventional machining, we are doing metals. So 3D printing around right now, the researchers are going on, and now some, they are started to do the stainless steel. Stainless steel is a metal, right? Stainless steel also, they are just printing. I already told you before 2 minutes or 3 minutes, stainless steel also they started to do, and the stainless steel which they manufactured using a 3D printer, it is 3 times stronger than the conventional one. Thank you, sir.
Next question from the same person. How long does it take to print something?
Okay, I just want to tell you this. It depends upon a thing. See, it's an additive manufacturing method. I already told it's not a fast process. It is not like a servant that immediately it should do. If it gives accuracy, it will need some time. One and only thing, if you want to do some product, if you are going to the market, you are ordering in Flipkart, Amazon, you are waiting for 2 or 3 days to be get delivered, right? There is no need of waiting for days and all. Morning you are giving, some 3 to 4 hours it will take for finishing a component. At least minimum 1 hour it will take to finish a small component, because it's an additive manufacturing. It needs some time for the material to get dried. So it's not a fast process. 1 hour it takes minimum to complete at least a bolt.
Thank you, sir. Next question is from Vishnu Vamsi. So he would like to know whether, suppose we have started one 3D printing work, in between there is power failure. So will the process resume or continue, or it will get completely disturbed?
Yeah. So actually, the problem with 3D printer is it will be get disturbed because it's a filler material. The temperature is always already set in it. So once the power failure occurs, there will be the temperature will gradually reduce. Again, if you the power comes, again, that it will take time. It will take time to start to heat again. Otherwise, there is a lot of things in it because it's heating the material and delivering it on the bed. If there is a power failure, the temperature will gradually come down. Again, if the power comes, if the temperature will rise. For it, it needs time. But we can start wherever we left. But it will take more time to get to the original temperature. Thank you, sir.
Last one more question I'll read out. That is, what are the disadvantages of 3D printer?
Disadvantages means the problem is still it is not known to many people, particularly in India. India is a democratic country, right? So if you want to make it reach to many people, it's very difficult because each and every person will have some different taste. Some say, okay, this I can do with my own hand. I can do better than this. And another, the thing did not reach. But once they use the 3D printer, they will just be knowing this. And another problem with 3D printer is gases. That means the filler material, suppose if the person is allergic to gas means the filler material will, if he just inhales the gases or resins, there is a prone of getting, you'll get giddiness. Sometimes it'll lead to fits or whatever it is, it'll lead to stroke. That is the main problem with 3D printer. The gases that comes, some gases that has to be gone through the outlet. Otherwise, it will inhaled inside. It will just damage our lungs or organs, whatever it is. It's a big problem for us. So we have to be careful in handling this. And one more thing, that cost. See the cost, 86,000 lower in price of the 3D printer is 86,000. 86,000 for us. It's a very big money. There is no doubt about it. It's not a small money. I told you it's lower end, but for middle class and upper middle class people, 86,000 is not a normal money. It is a big money for us. It's not a one day job to buy a 3D printer and become. It's a slow process. Once you prepare a toy using a 3D printer, if you want to sell it directly, people will not enjoy it. You have to create some websites, create some advertisements. You have to reach that level, you need time. And one more problem with 3D printer is time consuming. 1 hour you have to wait. Suppose your the patience you should have. These are some of the disadvantages of a 3D printing machine. And you have to, but there is a remarkable, I assure you that in another decade, definitely it will change. There is no doubt. Definitely will change. So I hope that I answered your question because there are some disadvantages, even though it is a sophisticated equipment, there will be some disadvantages in this. And moreover, people are misusing this technology. I already told you, they are manufacturing guns. It is offense. They will be behind the bars. So the people will easily misuse it. They will manufacture some cameras, camera stand also, spy cam cameras, like a button things also, they can finish in a fiber. That means they can do their own components. Lots and lots, even the hacking is the main problem now, internet hacking. They'll just design a device that can hack. So there is no need of, there'll be no proofs. If you do in your home, there is no proofs, right? So these are some of the problems. Thank you, sir.
Okay. There are many questions which are coming from the participants' end, but information I would like to give to all the participants that if you have any query, please put in our mail, that is info@onts.com. We will definitely get back to the speakers of today and we'll answer you soon. Maybe within a couple of days only, you will get your answers. Now, any two or three participants, if you want to speak anything or if you have anything to ask the speaker, then you can unmute yourself. You can raise your hand, then we'll unmute yourself and then you can ask your doubts. So first of all, Rajesh Kukati. If you are there, you can unmute. Yeah, continue. Please continue.
Thank you, sir. It was a nice session. Sir, I saw a commercial video of a company. In that, they printed the Abdul Kalam statue, sir. How they got the CAD model of Kalam, sir?
But it's very easy. Actually, it's just like a prototype, sir. You tell that Abdul Kalam statue, right? So there is a, if you know the dimensions of it, I mean Abdul Kalam's height or something, there you can manufacture it in your home thing. I mean, you need a printer of a bigger size. That's it. So you just not need to know the dimensions of it. Whatever, if you want to manufacture a humanoid or some human structure like it, you just want to know its dimensions. Even if you are knowing the dimensions and giving, if you are well versed in a drawing, if you are setting your system, you just give the height of Abdul Kalam, breadth, length and thing, and its complexion, jaw size and all, you can easily print it. Even if like just like designing a toy, but for a bigger length. That's it. You can just do it, sir, because 3D printing has a capability of doing complex structures. Doing a human like a statue, it is not a big problem for it. So one and only thing that drawing knowledge, if they are having, it is well and good. You can just do miracles in it. Thank you, sir.
One more note, sir. As like of that, can you do the statue of our own body, some human being?
We can. Sir, actually the thing is, right now, organs are not done. Still now the developments are not done in organs, but resembling our human body, we can do things, sir, because this is the outer part. Outer part you can do, just like as shown in your applications thing, that hand has been fixed. Outer parts, you can do whatever you want, because outer parts mean just dimensions. Suppose if you want to design your shoulders, the shoulders width and your thing, density, if it is known, the 3D printing bed just manufactures it and give it to you. It is just resembling exact thing of your shoulders. There will be no difference at all, because it takes your shoulders dimension, it stores your shoulders density, what type of breadth it is having, it manufactures it. But only problem with 3D printing is, still it is not done in any organs like heart or lungs, whatever it is, because it is inside. So there is no technology in that. It supports like it's scanning the body and doing. So it is a big problem in 3D printing. But still, in coming future, this also will be a achievement in 3D printing. But right now, if your dimensions is known, you can do your body parts also. Suppose if I'm knowing your body parts, I also can manufacture. If I'm having a big 3D printer, I can manufacture your exact statue also, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you so much. Now, Vicky Singh. Vicky Singh, if you have any query, you can ask.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Good evening, ma'am.
I'm Vicky Singh from Aurora College, sir. Sir, my question is that I have a 3D printer.
Okay, fine.
For printing a single 5 inches spring, is taking some 6 to 7 hours time, sir. So can you suggest me any printer which can work faster? Means not 6-7 hours, in 3 or 2 hours it can do.
Vicky Singh, what's the cost of your printer?
Some 5 lakhs rupees, sir.
5 lakhs, okay, fine. I'll just tell you one thing. Whenever you purchase in the mid-level, like 5 lakhs or 86, I told you, suppose if you purchase like this, definitely it will take more time. I mean, already it's additive manufacturing. I already told you need some patience. But right now, if I want to suggest you something, you can reduce the size of it. Otherwise, another thing is, what type of filler material you used? Can I know some raw material that will be reused, right? What type of raw material you used? Can I know the raw material that is used for you?
Hello, can you please unmute yourself once again?
Yeah, sir. PLA filament I'm using, sir, 1.7 mm.
Okay. See, there are some other filler materials. Actually, I didn't research regarding that. But the filler, you can reduce the time. I cannot tell you that you can get in a half an hour, 1 hour and all. But it will not take 6 to 7 hours. See, nylon is the most used filament that is used raw material. You just try the same thing with the nylon or something. It will be so you can just reduce the time also. 6 to 7 hours. That is a major problem with the 3D printing. Right now, the time consumption is a major issue. Even the operators are facing this issue. They are just developing some techniques that can reduce this. You know, not only you, Vicky Singh, many people are facing this issue. Even the person came inside and given the training to us, he also faced the issue. He just manufactured one block of a cube. For it, it took 1 to 1.5 hours. I just told you, right? So morning, if you're giving, till afternoon, you just finish off your works and...
Yeah, sir, actually for printing the 2 or 3 things, I have to wait totally whole day. So I want that any printer that can be print as soon as possible. I mean, not in half an hour, but minimum 2 to 3 hours, sir.
No chance, Vicky, because right now the researchers are going on to reduce the power time consumption, because in India, mass production is the one and only thing that 3D printing is not improving. Mass production means if you want to, they want some parts on the specified date. They need, they are not going for, they're just ordering that I need this on this date. But if you are having 3D printer, you cannot order the 3D printer to do it within half an hour, 1 hour.
Yeah.
Machine. So whenever it has to take the command, it has to give that and give. So it needs, it is also taking, it is also obeying us. And we have to wait for that to finish. But there will be advancement, Vicky. Right now, once you finish your education, you can see remarkable advancement in it, because they're just trying to make it fast. Like right now, they are taking the memory card and inserting. Right now, there is no need for it. Using a mobile itself, they can just do it. You're printing some 3D printers in your thing, you can just transfer it. There is no need of memory card getting, because there is a problem in memory card also. Suppose the memory card has some virus, it will affect the system. So if there is a Bluetooth device or a remote control device, through remote call also, there is some researchers are going on. Through remotes also, they are just operating it. So in the future, 6 to 7 hours will not happen. Definitely will come to 2 to 3 hours, Vicky. That is for sure.
Yeah, and sir, can you say, means if I will use any other type of filaments material, so I can reduce the time, sir?
Yeah, definitely. Because each and every filament has some characteristic. See, nylon is the best thing that is used by all. Around 60% of the 3D printing, 3D printers use my nylon or ABS, acrylonitrile butadiene styrene.
Yeah.
So these two materials they are using. These two materials, they are showing the results also. I have gone through some journals. In that 3 to 4 hours itself, they are yielded some good results. You can just change the filament material and just see, because I think your printing is FDM, fused deposition modeling. Definitely these two resin materials will work. You can just try over it, Ricky.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. So we have been getting many questions, and many participants are also willing to ask some doubts. But as we are running out of time, it will be difficult for us also to answer in this time span. But still, it is very good to for us that many participants have shown their interest towards this webinar or this program. And even they are trying to clarify their doubts. And once again, I am telling to all the participants that you can post your queries to info@onts.com. You can mail it us. So within 2 days only, you are going to get reply. We are going to put all your queries in front of our speaker, and definitely we are going to give you some answer. Now, to conclude, I, Anup Jana, Chief Manager, Business Operations and Development, Own Technology and Science, hereby thank Mr. Vigneswaran. Thank you so much, sir, for delivering such an engaging and enlightening note on 3D printing. I hope all the participants grabbed new insights from today's discussion and would make use of those to perform better researches and also to publish technically sound articles in reputed journals. We at Own Technology and Science are going to conduct many such useful webinars, short-term training programs, internships, and workshops in a wide range of areas related to engineering, management studies, diploma, career development, enhancing your communication skills, which are a few to name. One more thing also I'm going to add, that in future, own technology and science is also going to keep some courses on 3D printing, and that too live course, means hands-on training also we are going to arrange for 3D printing. And after in this session is over, once this session is over, in the WhatsApp group, we are going to send some videos where you can find that 3D printers are printing some object live. So those videos also we are going to share. As a part of our schedule, we are conducting a 2-week workshop on a C programming for beginners to experts, the schedule of which is like to be finalized shortly. And so all of you are requested to keep track on it in our website, www.ownts.com, for more details and registrations. There is another important announcement too. On the occasion of Independence Day, OTS is going to conduct an online competition, which includes painting, singing, brief technical talk, etc. Winners of this competition will be awarded prize and will be distributed on the Independence Day. There will also be a talk, live talk, on how technology brings freedom to us on the same day. There will not be any entry fee at all. Be sure about that. Details of this program also will be available in our official website. Now, I finally thank all the participants for participating in this webinar and making it a huge success. Thank you, one and all. Stay home, stay safe. Good night. One more announcement I would like to say, that this video, this entire session will be available in our YouTube channel. You can subscribe to that channel. Next time onwards, if there is any event, you can watch it live on that. Thank you so much, Vigneswaran sir, for your time in spite of busy schedule. You have given us time and you have given a wonderful session to all the participants.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. So wish all of you a happy future and good night. Thank you so much.